why did they draft Jordan Love? Why is no one mentioning that they have a future franchise quarterback that they invested a first-round pick in? The insinuation is when they drafted Jordan Love that 2022 was going to be the separation year.
2 years.
And Rodgers is trying to dictate the timetable of this by a year sooner than a year later. With this, after winning MVP.
The other way around, a year later than a year
sooner. Excuse me, yes, the other way around. He's saying, you know what, you're a year from now, you're going to be done with me based on the lack of big-time extension that I wanted in December and January. So let's just go ahead and part ways now. And according to reports from Trey Wingo last week, says that the Green Bay Packers, in fact, did tell him they were going to trade him this offseason. And then came forward with an extension that he didn't like, and now we're here. So, if you're Green Bay, what do you do? Is it repairable? That's the next thing. Is this repairable after him knowing that a year from now, we're right back where we are, except it's likely Green Bay will be done with him?
I would take a stock of how good is this GM if I were Green Bay? Because it's an easy solution. Get your guy to resign or fire him. And then Aaron Rodgers will be happy, and he'll be back in Green Bay. And I know that's a big risk for the precedent you're setting, but if you really believe in this GM and you know that he's done everything right, or you think he has, and he's doing everything he can to bring Aaron Rodgers back, and Aaron Rodgers being unreasonable, then you either trade him or let him walk. But if you really want Aaron Rodgers back, and you're not a full believer in the GM, get him out.
So,
because that's one way to guarantee that Aaron Rodgers is back with you and you can make a run at a Super Bowl title this year.
Gutekunst, the general manager, the report was from Charles Robinson of Yahoo.
Who's
excellent. And he did, in the report, he did not say that their Aaron Rodgers wants him, is demanding that he resign or be fired. The report stated, and I'm going to paraphrase it, it was that Rodgers doesn't believe that their relationship can continue on the path it's on. And so I believe that Charles Robinson would have directly said that Rodgers wants him out,
right,
if, in fact, that's what he wants done.
But he's saying that's the irreparable relationship.
Yes. That, and that LaFleur is the bystander here. He's just kind of going, you know, he's standing in front of a podium acting like he's not even contemplating
this
because
hired,
he's in love.
This guy hired LaFleur, right? He was part.
Yes.
Gutekunst was in place.
Yes.
So he was part of the triumvirate that hired, or the duo that hired Matt LaFleur. So he's got to defer to some degree to his boss.
Well, step one is somehow getting in front of Aaron Rodgers.
Correct.
If you're Gutekunst and talking with him and laying it all on the table. And falling on the
sword. They've got to have a meeting.
He needs to fall on the sword and say, I screwed up. You know, I should have told
you.
Well,
he has said that.
We should have talked about it.
Again.
He said that Thursday.
Has he said that to Aaron Rodgers, though?
I know he
said it publicly.
Aaron Rodgers doesn't pick up the phone for his family. I don't know if he's picking up the phone for the general manager.
I'm with you. But my point is, that's step one, is that they've got to somehow get in front of Aaron Rodgers. I don't care if it's ambushing him in California when he's hanging out with Shailene Woodley. Find a way to get in front of him, go to her next movie set or television show set, and find Aaron Rodgers and sit down and talk with him and apologize to him face-to-face and see if that helps.
You see, what's even crazier about that scenario would be the Green Bay Packers finding Shailene Woodley before the paparazzi came.
Yeah,
they've never been photographed together.
She's very reclusive.
And they're engaged.
Here's the key player in this whole thing.
Don't put the Titans on it. I'll tell you that much. I'll tell you who would not find out where Aaron Rodgers, Shailene Woodley are. The Tennessee Titans, that's for sure.
Here's the key player in this. David Dunn, Aaron Rodgers' agent. He's the broker in this, right? He's got to be the guy that has the come-to-Jesus meeting first with Rodgers. Say, look, maybe out isn't the best solution here. Maybe forcing that. Before we go forward with this, let's sit down with the Packers. They'll come to you. You know, I'll order croissants. We'll have a meal. Right? What kind of coffee do you want? You know, let's spend the morning with them and sit down and try one time to have a meeting. meditate, take a breather, do some yoga that morning, and let's go in calm. And they'll come in calm, and we'll talk. Right?
This is the most calm you've ever been, Paul.
That's funny, but this is what you need to do.
Yes.
To start. And then after that, we'll see how we feel.
Well, and the start has to be swallowing whatever pride and ego you have. If you're Gutenkist and saying, I really hate saying that name, but I'll say it anyways.
Yeah, we're doing well.
I'm trying to avoid saying it.
I was nailing Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoah.
It's not even, I know how to pronounce it, I hate saying it. It's one of those names, Gutenkist. But anyways, you go in there and you say, I'm completely in the wrong. You are our franchise as a player. We need to fix it. I want to consult you on things to do. I'm not going to give you overall say on who exactly we draft.
But let's
I don't think you want that. You can tell Aaron Rodgers that. But we should consult you more on these things and appease him the time that you have him there in any way that you can. And then if that relationship works out well, maybe at the end, the agent turns and says, now, Aaron, why don't you look over at this door also? Here are your parents.